Today I am going to take lecture on communication and modulation. Actually, I have to take lecture on modulation, but before discussing modulation, it is very important to discuss communication, because communication is the backbone of our modern society and we should understand different communication techniques and systems used in communication. As you know, we have started with simple communication, now it is 4G communication, and very soon we will be having 5G communication with higher speed. So what is communication? What is communication? It is the process of transmission or you can say transformation. Information. This is very important term, information. What do you mean by information? Information means voice signal, audio signal, and video signal. All these signals commonly known as information, which we want to send from one place to another place. From source to destination. What is source? Source is your transmitter. Destination is your receiver. So, communication is the process of transmission or transformation of information. Information in the form of voice signal, audio signal, video signal from source to destination means from transmitter to receiver. This is the simple meaning of communication. Now we will see the basic block diagram of communication system, of course wired communication system. Basic block diagram of wire सिस्टम। तो दिस कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ यू नो ब्लॉक डायग्राम, वी रिप्रेजेंट द कंपोनेंट एंड कंपोनेंट और द सोर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्लॉक एंड द नेम ऑफ ब्लॉक इज रिटन इनसाइड द ब्लॉक। सो दिस कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ सिंपल ब्लॉक, दिस इज इंफॉर्मेशन सोर्स, दिस इंफॉर्मेशन सोर्स इंफॉर्मेशन सोर्स एज आई टोल्ड यू इट इज इट मे बी वॉइस सिग्नल, इट मे बी वीडियो सिग्नल, इट मे बी ऑडियो सिग्नल। एंड वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू बिफोर गोइंग इन टू दिस, द वॉइस सिग्नल फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज इज हर्ज टू 3.4 किलो हर्ज, वेयर एज ऑडियो सिग्नल इज 20 हर्ज टू 20 किलो हर्ज, वीडियो सिग्नल अप टू 4.5 मेगा। So this is the range of this is from 0 to 4.5 megahertz. So now you must have understood what is information source. It may be voice, audio or video signal. Now you send this information through channel. So channel or wire, different types of cables in the electrical form. So you need a source transducer to convert this information into electrical form, and this information which is converted into electrical form, electrical signal, is being transmitted through channel. So transducer may be the mic may be a source transducer that converts your voice signal into electrical form, and its electrical form is being transmitted through channel. In wire channel may be you must be knowing coaxial cable. Coaxial cable, twisted pair cable, fiber optic cable, वायर्ड कम्युनिकेशन दिस इज फॉर शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस कम्युनिकेशन, शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस कम्युनिकेशन, वायर्ड कम्युनिकेशन इज यूज फॉर शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस कम्युनिकेशन. सो थ्रू दिस चैनल इट गोज टू रिसीवर ट्रांसड्यूसर, रिसीवर ट्रांसड्यूसर अगेन रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय ब्लॉक, that may be your loudspeaker, and then your information, that may be your voice, that is your destination. So from source to destination, your voice, audio signal or video signal is reached. So this is wired communication. This is called, this section is called transmitter, in short TX, and this is called receiver, in short it is receiver. A receiver transducer, as I told you, convert signal electrical to physical signal, voice signal, audio signal, video signal. So another this is for wired communication system, and block diagram of wireless communication is block diagram of wireless communication. Here channel is the free space. In wireless communication, channel is free space. So the block diagram is more or like the same, only there is absence of wire. This is information source, source transducer. You need a source transducer. Source transducer, and here you need a modulator. Modulator. So this is for modulation. So now you can imagine that why I discussed all these things before modulation, because we need a modulator here. Modulator work is to modulate the signal, and this is transmitted through antenna, and it is received by the antenna at the destination, and this signal is decoded बाय डी मॉड्यूलेटर देन दिस गोज टू रिसीविंग ट्रांसड्यूसर receiving transducer and then to destination. So here the channel is free space, transmission and reception of signal is being done through free space. Everything is same, only we added modulator and demodulator and also antenna for transmission of signal. So you can well understand the use of modulation in communication. Now few types of signals we must know before going to discuss the modulation, that is baseband signal. What is baseband signal? It is a low frequency signal is a low frequency signal having lower cutoff frequency, lower cutoff frequency either 0 or very close to 0. Such signal is called baseband signal. If you see the frequency domain diagram, so upper cutoff frequency, which is so higher cutoff frequency. What is here? Higher cutoff frequency, this is omega m, and lower cutoff frequency, it is 0. So bandwidth will be omega m minus 0 is equal to omega m. So this is बेस बैंड सिग्नल, इट इज अ लो फ्रिक्वेंसी सिग्नल हैविंग लोअर कट ऑफ फ्रिक्वेंसी आइदर जीरो और वेरी क्लोज टू जीरो एंड इट्स बैंड विड्थ इज ओमेगा एम. सिमिलरली वी शुड ऑल्सो नो बैंड पास सिग्नल. What is band pass signal? It is a high frequency signal having its lower cutoff frequency very greater than zero. If you see the Fourier diagram, this is answer. This is zero, this is lower cutoff frequency, this is higher cutoff frequency. USB, LSB, FH. So this is bandwidth of band pass signal. And depending on the relationship on the relationship between bandwidth and higher cutoff frequency, we can categorize band pass signal into two parts: narrow band signal and wide band signal. In narrow band signal, bandwidth is very less than higher cutoff frequency, or you can say FH by bandwidth, this should be greater than 1. In this case, the band pass signal is called narrow band signal, and in wide band signal, bandwidth is very nearly equal to higher cutoff frequency. So in this case you can say it is a wide band signal. So Now I will discuss the concept of modulation to you. In modulation, I change this color red. In this modulation, this involves three signals. First is modulating signal. The second is carrier signal, and third is the product of the modulator, the modulated signal. So before discussing modulation, we should understand all the three signals. Modulating signal means the signal you want to modulate to send from one place to another place. It is a long distance communication. In long distance communication, we need modulation. You can well understand from a analogous example that a person is ill and he want to go from one place to another place. Since he is ill, he is not able to walk, how he can reach at a distant place? So if you provide him a motor car, then he will reach there. So the person is your modulating signal, motor car is your carrier signal, and combinedly is called modulated signal. So your modulating signal is your information, information, carrier signal is high frequency signal of the order of megahertz, this is carrier signal. So we can understand modulating signal is denoted by MT as a function of T, and carrier signal is denoted by C as a function of T. It is a time domain representation, and modulated signal S as a function of T. So we represent CT AC cos 2 pi FC T, okay, and modulating signal is MT. So modulated signal ST is MT CT. If you this is U1 and this is 2, so if you put 1 in 2, we get ST is equal to MT cos 2 pi FC T, and if you do Fourier transformation of this, then it will be AC by 2 M F plus FC USB plus M F minus FC LSB. So this is the frequency domain representation. Of modulation, what idea we get from modulation? This is very important concept. From these equations, what we get by modulation? So, as you see, the low frequency signal MT, मतलब signal from low frequency signal to high frequency signal, when it is combined with the carrier signal. So, we get the signal. Oh, okay, okay. Let me the idea we get by modulation is the signal is translated. From low frequency region to high frequency region. One thing, when we superimpose MT on CT, that is given by the product of these two, this means signal is translated from low frequency region to high frequency region. And second is the baseband signal is converted into band pass signal. This is the crux of modulation, and you should understand. Third is a wide band signal a wide band signal becomes narrow band signal. Narrow band signal. It is denoted by this formula very nicely, HF by LF very greater than 1, then it is called narrow band, and when HF LF is nearly equal to 1, it is called wide band. The ratio of high frequency to low frequency is very greater than 1, then it is called narrow band. When it is nearly equal to 1, then it is called wide band signal. So this is the concept of modulation. So modulation, you can say, is a process of, now we can conclude that the modulation is the process of superimposing or upshifting, because low frequency signal is transferred from low frequency region to high frequency region. So is a process of superimposing or upshifting. Upshifting of frequency of low frequency, of course, of information signal or you can say baseband signal on high frequency carrier signal by altering characteristics of what? Carrier signal. Altering sum of the characteristics . What are these characteristics? Amplitude, frequency, and phase. These characteristics are changed when you change amplitude characteristic. It is called amplitude modulation. When we change frequency, it is called frequency modulation. When we change phase, it is called phase modulation. So now the question arises, what is the need of modulation? Need of modulation. You must have understood and have some idea what is the need of modulation. So the important use of modulation is reduces uses height of antenna. As you know, practical antenna length is 4, where lambda is c by nu or f. Suppose we use low frequency for transmission. Means transmission frequency is 15 kilohertz. 15 kilohertz. So lambda will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second C, and this is 15 into 10 to the power 3. 20,000 meter. So practical antenna length, if you determine, is 20,000 by 4. This means 5 kilometer. So this is just impossible to fabricate such antenna. But as you know, if you take high frequency transmission, f is suppose 15 megahertz, then lambda will be how much? 20 meter. Lambda by 4 will be 5 meter. So this is possible. So height of the antenna is reduced when we use high frequency signal for transmission from one place to another place. So height of antenna required for transmission and reception of radio waves in radio transmission is a function of frequency. So the minimum height of antenna, as you see, is lambda by 4. From above example, it is clear that transmission frequency should be high so as to have practical antenna length. Now again, another importance you need of modulation is increase range of communication. Voice can be sent from one place to another place simply without the use of modulation. But if you speak it at a short distance, it can be heard. But as you go at a larger distance, you will not be able to hear the voice. So as you know, the famous Planck formula, E is equal to h nu. At low frequency, the radiation is poor and signal get highly attenuated. Therefore, baseband signal cannot be transmitted over larger distance because energy is low. Low frequency, the radiation will be poor. This will be dissipated in the space. But modulation effectively increases the frequency of signal to be radiated and thus increase the distance over which signal can be transmitted faithfully because of use of carrier. Next need is avoids mixing of signals. Suppose you have one signal kilohertz, another signal 3 kilohertz, yet another signal 3 kilohertz. So due to modulation you will get all the three separated by guard band. It is centered at 3 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz. So modulation process translate different baseband signal at different carrier frequency so that spectrum overlapping do not take place and mixing of signal can be avoided. Another is need of modulation is that it allows multiplexing of signal. As you see from the earlier example, what do you mean by multiplexing? What do you mean by multiplexing? But in multiplexing, it is a transmission of two or more signals simultaneously. Over same channel. Or you have seen in earlier example that modulation process translate different baseband signal and different carrier frequency so that they can be simultaneously transmitted without any loss of information. So we have learned these need of modulation. Another one is it modulation improve quality of reception. The signal communication using modulation technique as you know like FM, PCM. This reduces noise to great extent. Reduction of noise is a major problem in any communication system, and if it reduces noise means improvement in the quality of reception. So that's all today.